Ancient Egypt, known for its wealth, funerary customs, and antiquity. Nubia, a country of abundance with its natural resources of gold, ebony, and ivory. Two adjacent countries rich in culture and mystique have a long-standing history initiated by trade but made complex by bitter rivalry. With Nubia having an exorbitant wealth of natural goods, Egypt recognized these assets and initiated trade with Nubia, relying heavily on Nubia's gold resources as their primary currency. Eventually, this would not sit well with Egyptian leaders to be dependent on a country substantially close to their own. Subsequently, Nubia was invaded by Egypt. In turn, elite Nubians embraced the cultural and spiritual aspects of Egyptian life. The two cultures blended, with Egypt being the highly documented dominant force for a number of years. However, what consistently goes unrecognized by Egyptologists is the change of the tide, Nubia's rise to power over Egypt. In 2008, National Geographic magazine published a compelling article on the rarely acknowledged occurrence of Egypt under Nubian leadership. It was the 25th dynasty, and Egypt suffered from inner political turmoil. Nubian ruler Pharaoh Pie felt the only way to save Egypt was to invade it. This was a year-long campaign of siege throughout the Egyptian landscape. The vanquished, adhering to Pie, with offers to worship at their temples, the finest gold, and the best horses. The pharaoh's successor, his brother Shabaka, also ruled an old pharaonic tradition, restoring temples and building dikes to seal off Egyptian villages from Nile floods. Egyptian society as a whole thrived and prospered under a significant era of Nubian rule. Yet somehow, these rulers go largely ignored, their accomplishments diminished by many scholars and Egyptologists, namely for the darkness of their complexions. Even Dr. George Reisner, famed Harvard Egyptologist who offered the first archaeological evidence that Nubian kings ruled over Egypt, also states that Nubian cultures are not as developed as their superior Egyptian neighbors. The Egyptians were elevated far above the inert mass of the black races of Africa, according to Dr. Reisner. The question remains, what makes a pharaoh with darker skin inferior to a pharaoh with lighter skin? Was ethnicity really a factor in ancient times? And lastly, why are bias and discriminatory evidence still so readily accepted in the field of Egyptology? Inquiring minds want to know. Whoa. Whoa.